Hello, I'm Dr. Aizaz from MedicoVisual.com, and in today's visual lecture, we will discuss about the development of nails. So, the nails start developing with a thickening of the ectoderm at the fingertips. So, here we can see the fingertips. So, at the tip of the fingertips, basically at the fingertips, there is a thickening of ectoderm here. You can see this thickening of ectoderm. These thickenings of ectoderm are called nail fields. So all these, of course, they are bilaterally. On the other hand as well, there are these thickenings, and these are called nail fields. And these nail fields, initially they are at the tip and at the ventral side, but later what actually happens that they move dorsally. So they will migrate from here dorsally like this. And of course, as they migrate, they will take their nerve supply with them. Now, what happens with the nail fields? To understand this, I will isolate a single finger, because the same process is going on with all the fingers. And by the way, here I am showing the development of fingernails, but the nails of your feet, the toenails, they also develop with a very similar process. The process of development is very similar. The only difference is that if the development of fingernails starts today, let's suppose, then the development of toenails will start 4 weeks later. So there is this gap of 4 weeks between the development of fingernails and toenails. So around this nail field, around this single nail field, the tissue around it proliferates and form elevations like this. So, tissue around it proliferates to form elevations around it. Now, if I cut a section of this, we can see what's going on inside. So, inside it, basically we have the dermis. This greenish one is representing the dermis of the skin. So, what will happen that this nail field, it will invaginate deep into this dermis. It will grow within this dermis. It will form a fold basically, and that fold will grow into this dermis, proximally deep into this dermis like this. So like this, this is the situation. So initially it was simply a thickening of ectoderm, the nail field, but now it has formed a bed for the development of nail. So this structure, basically this structure here, this part of nail field, now it is called, this part is called, this is called nail bed. So it means that our nail will grow on this bed. So this is nail bed. And this proximal extension, or you can say proximal invasion of the dermis, this one, this proximal invasion of the dermis by this nail field, this one, this part basically. Now this part is termed as nail matrix. So this is nail matrix. And especially, okay, let's write it first. So this is nail matrix, especially this part, this lower part. This lower part especially, it consists of lots of germinative cells, cells that have potential to germinate, and they, what they will do is that they will proliferate and they will keratinize and they will form a hard curved plate, and that hard curved plate is the actual nail itself. Let me show you the animation. So from this part of the nail matrix, especially this part is considered the nail matrix, but some authors considered whole this structure as nail matrix. But anyhow, this part, the cells from this part, they will proliferate, they will undergo keratinization, and they will undergo cornification. All this process is very similar to how the hair develops. So I will not go into details in this lecture again. It is very similar to development of hair. Here also, in case of nails, here also the keratin is hard type of keratin. So from here, the actual nail will arise like this. And this actual nail, the one, the structure that we typically refer to as nail, this structure is called, technically it is called, what it is called nail plate. It's a curved translucent plate. So nail plate, and below it, this one is the nail bed. If you see carefully, this part is the nail matrix, or at least this part is the nail matrix. Nail matrix is basically the posterior or proximal or deeper or dermal extension of the nail bud. So this is nail matrix. Nail matrix is proximal continuation. Nail matrix is proximal continuation of the nail bed. I hope you understood this point. So basically, this is all about the development of nail. It's very easy to understand. It's not complicated at all. It's very easy to understand. Of course, there are few things that can be discussed when it comes to histology of the nail, but I will avoid that in this lecture. But a few things that I would like to discuss here before concluding this lecture. Of course, it's a small lecture and it's a relatively easy topic. So yeah. So now you can see there is this fold of skin above this nail, near the root of this nail. Oh, what is the root of nail, by the way? Actually, this term nail root, it is relatively confusing term. Let me tell you, there is a term called nail root. Most of the textbooks and most of the authors call this part of the nail plate, this proximal part, this earlier part, this deeper part of nail plate, which is hidden under the skin, this deeper part of the nail plate, this deeper part of nail plate is typically referred to as nail root, deeper part of, or proximal most part of nail plate is referred to as nail root. But as it typically happens with medical sciences, there is always some confusion. So some authors, they like to call this initial part of nail bed, or which is actually the nail matrix. So they use the term, this is nail matrix. Basically, some authors, they use the term nail matrix interchangeably with nail root. So they use these terms as synonymous terms, but this is very confusing. I don't think so that it should be used that way. This earlier part, this proximal part of the nail plate itself, which should be called nail root. So this second thing, nail matrix, calling the nail matrix as nail root is very confusing, and I suggest that it must be avoided. But anyhow, some very authoritative and some very famous textbooks, they do this thing. I don't know why they are doing, but what can we do? That is what it is. So anyhow, and so I was telling you that here you can see that this part of nail is covered by this skin fold. Initially, it is covered almost completely with a skin fold, but later what happens that the distal part of this skin fold degenerates, and only it remains at the proximal end. It remains here at the proximal end. So this nail fold covering the nail root is called, it has a very unique name. It is called aponychium. Yeah, aponychium. This is aponychium. And here at the distal end, here we have the free margin of the nail plate. Near its free margin, here the distal end, here this 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 part of skin. It is thickened and it is tightly adherent with this with the nail bed and this part of nail plate. This is called hyponychium. Yeah, so we have these two terms, aponychium, this skin fold here, and this thickened skin here at the distal end. This is hyponychium. So these few terms that you must know. So in the end, the single take home message of this lecture that you must remember is that the nail develops from a single word, you know, nail develops from ectoderm. So from ectoderm, nail develops. I think arrow should be like this. So nail develops from ectoderm. This is single most thing that you must remember. Other things you can learn in anatomy and histology, but when it comes to embryology, single most thing that you must remember that nail arises from ectoderm. So that was all about the development of nail. So thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day. Goodbye.